If you were to choose a nameplate that, above all others, best encapsulates what Alfa Romeo stands for, few would question your judgment if you picked the original Giulietta from the 1950s. Fun to drive, technically sophisticated and, in most versions at least, drop dead gorgeous to look at, the Giulietta represents Italy's incredible post-war renaissance better than perhaps anything else. Revered by collectors since at least the 1980s, the story of the Giulietta has been very well documented, but I bet you didn't know these five little factoids about it. Sit back and enjoy. The Shakespearean name of Giulietta came about one day at the home of the poet Leonardo Sinis Galli, a good friend of Alfa's president Giuseppe Luraghi. Up to that point, Alfa Romeos had never been given proper names, but rather numbers and acronyms. Luraghi wanted a change, though, and Sinis Galli's wife, overhearing the conversation, suggested Giulietta for Alfa's new passenger car and Romeo for the new panel van, which were unveiled contemporarily at the Portello factory in 1954. The Giulietta Sprint Speciale, introduced in 1959, was a gorgeous rolling sculpture from the creative genius of Franco Scaglione. The whole design was driven by the desire to lower drag to achieve a higher top speed. However, during testing, the windscreen wipers tended to lift off the screen during high-speed runs. To counter that, all the Sprint Speciale were fitted with a transparent plastic element called diruttore, which diverted the airflow away from the wiper blades. In 1950s Italy, station wagons were perceived as workhorses rather than practical family cars, so demand for a wagon derivative of a relatively expensive car like the Giulietta was very limited. It's therefore believed that just 91 Giuliettas were ever converted into wagons between 1957 and 1960 by the Milanese coachbuilder Colli, and that the vast majority went to the Polizia Stradale, the Italian highway police. In 1960, the Milanese coachbuilder Colli built a stretch limousine of a Giulietta berlina, called Ministeriale, referencing its intended use for public institutions and livery services. However, it's believed that only the prototype appearing in this picture was ever produced. The Giulietta berlina was discontinued in 1964. But as late as 1963, Alfa Romeo seriously considered the possibility of extending the model's lifespan through a heavy restyling. The Carrozzeria Bertone delivered the prototype in these pictures in February of 1963 for evaluation by Alfa Romeo's management, but the idea was abandoned shortly after. And if you want to discover more obscure Alfa Romeo trivia, please feel free to check out either one of the two videos appearing on your screen right now. I'm sure you won't be disappointed.